Hi, my name is Kylie, and welcome to The Planets One. In this video series, you'll become an expert on the eight planets in our solar system. Eight? You may think there are nine. You'll find out why there are only eight and other facts about the amazing and interesting planets that orbit our sun. This video will look at the first couple planets, and our next two videos will take a look at the remaining five planets and Pluto. Get ready to launch into space. Our sun is at the center of our solar system. It is so huge, it has tremendous energy and gravity. Gravity, the same force that keeps you on Earth without flying off into space, is what keeps planets close to it. Planets circle around or orbit the sun. There are at least eight planets, including Earth. Here are the planets in order from our closest to our farthest from the sun. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. There's one more, Pluto, that we will discuss in a bit. Astronomers sort of argue about Pluto. There are a lot of neat ways to remember them in order, but I like to use this sentence. My very educated mother just served us noodles. Each letter of the words in the sentence are the first letters of the planets in order from our sun. Let's take a look at the first few planets. We will start out with the closest planet to our sun and work our way out. Mercury is the smallest planet in our solar system and is about one-fifth the size of Earth. It is about as wide as the United States. Since it is only about 29 million miles away from the sun, Mercury gets very, very hot. During the day, the surface temperature on Mercury can reach 800 degrees Fahrenheit. That is hot enough to melt some metals. Scientists believe that Mercury is composed of, or made up of, a metal and rock. They also think there was once a lot of volcanic activity because there are a lot of craters on Mercury's surface. Mercury has no moons or rings circling it. One day on Mercury takes just over 58 Earth days to complete, but one year on Mercury only takes about 88 Earth days. So, if we were ever able to visit Mercury, days would take forever to be over, but years would fly by in about 3 of our months. The gravity on Mercury is different from ours, too. If you weigh 100 pounds on Earth, you will weigh only 37.8 pounds on Mercury because the force of Mercury's gravity is not as strong as Earth's gravitational pull. The second planet from the sun is Venus. Venus is our closest neighbor. Astronomers often call Venus our twin because it is very close to the size of Earth. You can sometimes see Venus without using a telescope, and you can see it like a bright star shining in the sky depending upon where you live and if the sky is clear at night. Venus has a very rocky composition. This means it is made up of mostly rock. It is always covered by thick clouds, and astronomers could only tell what was under the clouds by sending a small space probe to Venus in the 1980s and 1990s. Venus has no moons or rings circling it. Its temperatures reach that of Mercury. Venus spins, or rotates, much more slowly than Earth, and it rotates in the opposite direction of Earth and the other planets. On Earth, a one-day rotation takes 24 hours. On Venus, one rotation takes 5,832 hours. That's 243 Earth days. Yikes! That's actually longer than Venus takes to travel or orbit around the sun. So it may be a little hard to imagine, but a day on Venus takes longer than a year on Venus. Pretty weird, huh? The gravity on Venus is almost the same as ours. If you weigh 100 pounds on Earth, you would weigh 90.7 pounds on Venus. Earth is, of course, our home and is the third planet from the sun. Our planet is the only one in the solar system to have a habitable atmosphere. This means our atmosphere has what we need to have life on our planet. This includes oxygen and water vapor. Earth's day lasts 24 hours because that is how long it takes to rotate or spin on its axis. The axis is an imaginary line running through the middle of the planet. It helps to imagine a basketball player spinning a ball on her finger. Earth's year is about 365 days. This is because it takes 365.25 days to travel in orbit around the sun. An orbit is the path a planet travels around the sun. However, every 4 years, Earth has a leap year. This means instead of 365 days, we have 366 days. We do this by adding a day in February, February 29th. That extra one quarter of a year is what is left over to make that extra day every 4 years. Earth is made of mostly rock, both solid and liquid forms. The surface of Earth is made up of mountains and flat spaces called plains and valleys. The surface of the Earth is covered in 71% water. Almost all of that water is salt water in our oceans. Earth has a range of temperatures from negative 126 degrees Fahrenheit to 136 degrees Fahrenheit. Those are, of course, the extremes. Most people live in an area of the Earth that ranges from about negative 58 degrees to 110 degrees Fahrenheit. The Earth has one moon and no ring circling it. A moon is a natural or not man-made object that orbits a planet. Astronomers also call moons and rings natural satellites. Rings are made up of lots of tiny particles of dust, rocks, ice, or other materials. We also have hundreds of man-made satellites circling our planet. We launch these satellites into orbit around our planet using rockets. They're used for communication, like some cell phone signals, for researching outer space, and for holding astronauts like the International Space Station. We have just went through a lot of amazing facts about the first three planets in our solar system. We've taken a journey through them one by one, and I hope you've enjoyed the trip. For the next part of our journey, check out our video, The Planets 2, which will pick up where we left off. In that video, we'll take a look at the next three planets. If you'd like to learn about astronomy, which is the study of outer space, check out our other astronomy and science videos and games. Remember to always be clever.